What is happening, people? It is BA, and today I'm going to be reacting to the film Us. It's been on my radar for a little bit now. I watched the previous film by the same writer called Get Out, which was a great horror film. I'm a big fan of the horror genre anyway. So let's get into it. Let's see what this film's saying to it. I rate that production company logo. Bit of stop motion animation.
From sea to shining sea. That's right. This summer, 6 million people will tether themselves together to...
This is a real thing. It's quite a strange tradition.
About how you can be a part of Hands Across America.
I don't see the point.
Tell you what. Right now, you could walk away with a prize from the second level. Or you could keep going for a prize from the third level.
Take the gamble.
That shirt better not give her nightmares.
I guarantee that Michael Jackson shirt gives her nightmares. You are being such a stereotypical person in a horror film right now. Go get your dad. You can just tell already this is like so well filmed and lit. Everything, you could pause it and it's like a dope picture. I love these sets like this, like Disney ghost rides and shit. That's a very good use of that effect to disguise the exit. See, that's the one thing I know about this film. It's like, it's about duplicates or some sort of thing like that, where there's like replicas of them that are not quite them. That's the only thing I know about it, so. Okay, I don't know if this rabbit hutch thing is like hinting at cloning or, I mean, I don't get. This is obviously metaphorical for the explanation to this film. But I'm not quite sure as to what, in what way yet. Kids are sleeping.
We made it!
Because
I sleep too much.
That would piss me off to be woken up like that. They took it well.
I'm not going to make it to the Olympics, guys.
You could do anything you set your mind to.
Can I drive while we're up here?
Nope.
No.
Well, that's what I set my mind to.
Can't argue with that logic. Pretty sound.
We're going to the beach.
Yeah. Josh, Kitty, and the girls are going to be there.
So if that's the same beach from the intro. So I'm assuming she is the little girl from the start.
Okay, she got lost. The 15 minutes, that's...
That can be very scary.
You don't know what happened to her.
I wonder if she is already like a replacement. Like a replicant. She looks a bit already a replacement-y, if that's a way to describe someone. She's very already a place replacement-y.
There's like, it's crowded there, and like, there's weirdos at the beach, and I'm not going to that.
There is weirdos at every beach.
At least I got it really cheap.
We'll be
Craw
all
daddy, big, you know.
You know what? Y'all are spoiled.
Agreed. That's a banging boat. I would not sniff at that boat. I've never even been on a powered motorboat that I could call my own once in my life. Don't laugh at the man's boat.
What does I Got Five on me?
It's about drugs.
It's not about...
It's actually about sharing, community, and brotherhood. Coming together when times are hard in order to help out all through no selfishness. By buying drugs.
Hey!
Hey, what's up?
This is the creepiest beach music I've ever heard.
What? I have a hard time just, you know, talking.
There's definitely something off with the mum. Something happened to her when she was a little girl at the beach there.
Stick with me. I'll keep you safe, okay?
She's like the John Wick of mums.
Now, I was thinking about getting some fishing gear tomorrow. Four rods, we could all go fish off the dock.
Nice. Sounds like a good day.
Of course, there's the boat too.
He's desperate for his boat to get some action.
Okay, we lost power. Go back to bed.
There's a family in our driveway.
There is not a family in our
driveway. Okay, now it's getting creepy.
It's just a family standing outside. It's probably the neighbors.
Weird neighbors.
I have a vacation and my whole family lost their goddamn minds.
Straight up, I would do the same thing. What's a family of four gonna do to you?
So if y'all wanna get crazy, we can get crazy. Now the cops are already on their way.
The way he lowered his toenail. Damn, scaling the trees and shit.
If I were you...
You might notice I'm not jumping to any of these jump scares. I'm a bit jump scare resilient at this point. You live long enough, nothing really jolts you. You expect everything. Of course there's a weird-faced little kid that just popped up at the window. That's normal. Have you ever lived in Glasgow? That chick climbed all the way up to the roof just to break back down to the ground floor. I feel a bit sad for her wasted effort.
Once upon a time.
Fucking hell.
But the shadow. She came back to a little monster.
This is excellent acting, by the way. I'm just quiet because this is incredible.
What do you want? You could have my wallet. You could have the boat for all I care.
Nobody wants the boat, Dad.
I would have had the boat. I'll take the boat. She's gonna be obviously equally as good at running. Oh shit.
What the fuck? Get off my car!
I was not expecting this dude to just come in and kill the tension like that. That's incredible. He's probably about to die, but that in and of itself was hilarious.
I said, come here. Get talking to you. Ah! Ah!
Ah! That was straight in there.
I call it the untethering.
That's an amazing camera shot with a reflection in the table glass there. And that also, the voice that woman is choosing to use for that character, yeah, that could have been heavy hit or miss, and it is, like, she pulled it off excellently. It's not cheesy, it's weird, but in a good way. It's just some creepy, like, mummy sound or something. She literally sounds like an Egyptian mummy or something, but it's working very well for the character. I'd like to think, yeah, that the creepy version of the dad appreciates the boat like the dad does. If they're the same, then literally he's the only other person in the world that will connect with him on the fact that the boat's actually dope and everybody else is just a boat hater. So these two might end up making friends on this lake. I mean, it's not looking likely.
Come on.
Yeah. Now who's saving the day? The boat. The boat. Don't want to hear another bad word about Crawdaddy, because in a crutch moment, he just saved the fucking day.
There's something out there.
Don't fuck with me, Josh.
I'm not fucking with you. I'm serious. There's something out there. Look, that's OJ Simpson.
What is wrong with you?
They've set this guy up to be such a dick that I feel that this scene will end in him dying. If this is anything like a normal horror film, he will die within the next 5 minutes.
Hello?
Oh my God!
Don't
Sizzles. And yeah, within 5 minutes, it was like within 1 minute 30. There's no way this version of that guy, by the way, can be any more of a dick than the one he just killed. So technically, this is probably a good guy replacing a dickhead. In which case, murder is justified. As if she's making her last dying action to crawl closer toward this total dickhead. See, this one's got a bit of humor.
Wait, stop.
Stopping. Good Vibrations by the Beach Boys.
It's test footage from Joaquin Phoenix's audition for the Joker there. I was hoping that was going to go straight in his face. We all were. They knew it's what I wanted to see. And they purposely just made it fizzle and fall below his fucking legs as a fuck you for trying to predict what's going to happen in this film. Didn't they? I accept it. They flare-gunned me to the face instead. And it hurts with a burning, fizzly sensation. Go fuck yourselves.
And then we just saw red.
Oh, you saw red?
Yes, they were wearing red. They didn't look right. They had scissors and they were just walking up to people.
Red and scissors. What the There's going to be a reveal. There's a laboratory. There's rabbits they were forced to eat. I've got part of the fucking puzzle together here, but why would there be duplicates?
I'm driving. No way.
I told her no.
You're handcuffed. It's not safe. I'm driving. Zora, no.
I have the highest kill count in the family.
You don't have the highest kill count.
So that's 1, 1, 1, and 2. I killed 2. I killed myself and Josh, so.
Zora, it doesn't matter. Zora, get in the back.
I rate that that's how they're determining who gets to drive. I would want the driver to have the highest kill count myself.
You're going too fast!
Holy fuck, she launched her. Fucking hell. She's still trying to kill her even though she's that fucked up herself. That is an unrelenting hatred slash creepiness.
It's a trap.
Ah, shit. About to light that fuel on fire. So, I don't understand it if, like, he has to copy him or what. So he's walking him back into the flaming car. That's a pro gamer move. Fucking hell. You know what? I thought that was an actual fence there. And then I just realised what I was looking at. They are taking this Hands Across America shit very seriously. I feel bad for the ones that are in the sea having to do it. Just casually drowning as to not break the human daisy chain. So here we are. Right back to the start. So in a traditional horror, this would be her entering the belly of the beast. So I wonder if finally now we're going into this place, there's going to be some reveals. Perhaps you'll find a secret entrance to somewhere. Okay, so secret entrance check. This thing just goes down and down. I mean, this has got to be military. Surely it's got to be military or government in some way. So are the government duplicating people and holding a copy prisoner or the original prisoner? Okay, we have reached the rabbits. And they've been fucking.
On that one.
Yeah, I guess I missed my
chance to go. I was hoping we would get to see more of this flashback story because I think there's more to it than we first saw. Alright, fuck, it's showing you the same thing happening inside the facility. So, like, is it because they were mirrored, they just so happened to go to the point that would actually lead them to make contact or whatever? When your opponent thinks of the mountains, go to the sea. Book of Five Rings. That must have killed her, surely. If they are in fact only just human, that was pretty much directly through the heart. Fucking hell. She's doing an incredible job acting this part. And both parts if it's the same actress, but specifically her underground side is like an excellent performance. And I think we are finally safe.
Just want my little girl.
So did she actually swap places with her back then? Well, I sort of thought it might have been some sort of switcheroo like that because of the way they were acting weird back in the day, but still, that's creepy. So she's basically just killed the real version of herself at the end there. And the real version of herself has been trying to escape ever since she was a little girl. Kind of a weird happy ending. Alright, so that was us and I will be back in just a minute with my thoughts. Okay, so I just watched Us for the first time, directed and written by and everything else by Jordan Peele, the second horror film I've seen of his after Get Out. I thought it was really great. First of all, it was brilliantly filmed and brilliantly acted. I've never seen any of the actors in anything before, but I will be definitely checking out the stuff they do in the future, especially, I forget the name of the female lead, but whoever played the mother, both sides of that character were done excellently. Jordan Peele always thinks of, like, I love his horror concepts, because he thinks of horror concepts very similar to, like, when I'm writing sort of horror-related stuff, I'm very inspired by the original Twilight Zones and any sort of anthology horror. Anthology horror, if you don't know what that means, is basically short stories, sometimes interwoven, sometimes not. So if it's an anthology film, like, you'll get maybe 4 or 5 20-minute stories in it. Or like the ABCs of Death had 26 very, very short ones. So that's anthology horror. So I'm very inspired by that. And I can tell that Jordan Peele is one of these writers that is also a big fan of those sorts of things. He even did the Twilight Zone remake, which I still haven't seen yet. I might react to in future. But just his conceptually, you can tell that he loves those little weird sort of twist things. Very similar to M. Night Shyamalan. You can tell he was a big fan of Twilight Zone and stuff like that because of the little strange twists at the end. Everything had a weird thing you weren't expecting about to pop up. And for that reason, I really liked the story because just like in Get Out, there's a big mystery, what's going on, you don't know what's going on, and then in the final act, it's revealed obviously that these people are getting their brains taken out and bodies swapped and shit. And again, in this, something's going on. You're trying to put the pieces together, but the reveal was kind of even creepier. I figured that as soon as I saw the facility, I figured obviously the government had to have built it or the military. I still didn't understand the reasons. I assumed they were just experimenting, but it wasn't an experiment. It was actually a project to duplicate people, and then you were able to control their selves up above due to the fact that there is only one soul. So if you could make the people down below do something, the person up above had to do something because the soul was shared, is, I believe, like the twist from what I gathered from it. But then there was also the double twist, of course, which, to be honest, I genuinely thought that is what had happened at the beginning. As soon as the beginning finished, the way it cut away just as the girl turned around to see the duplicate of herself, I knew there was more to that story than just her seeing that. And also, she did later say that she just saw it and ran out, but I was like, well, you'd lost the way out. How could you just run out? The exit sign was pinging off of like 50 mirrors and you were like stuck in there. So I don't see how she was able to just run out. So I figured something like that had happened, but it was still interesting when you found out that's what had happened, for the fact that, like I said, I genuinely don't know who you feel more sorry for in that scenario. The person that was cloned as a child and raised to the age of a young child in a facility, who then escaped and got to live a long, happy life, or the person that was born naturally, freely on the upper world, even though technically they weren't free because they were being controlled, that's another matter. The person up there got to live a free life until they were that same age, and then for the rest of their life were imprisoned until, you know, the untethering, the day of reclamation. So I don't know who you would feel more sorry for. I liked the set pieces. I liked how, by the way, I did think they were bringing that little magic trick back into it so that he would light something later on. Never happened. Bit of a shame. But yeah, and the Pyromaniac song was cool. It was, what another thing I noticed was, it was like almost like every family member was kind of like a classic horror trope, if that makes sense. Like the girl was the creepy smiley one that will just pursue you, not say anything. The boy was like that feral character, the monster. He was literally growling all the time. He's like a representation of like a wolf man. And then the dad was just making big noises and using brute strength, proper like a sort of Frankensteinian, sort of Lorch ogre-y type. And yeah, and then the mother was like an Egyptian zombie, with the way she spoke and the way she was the hierarchical character orchestrating shit and that. It was almost like they were all like universal monsters, almost. Kind of. Like, yeah. It's quite strange, but I think it worked really well because you could have had them all come up from this facility and all just be crazy. Like, when you see a zombie movie, zombies don't have differing personalities, do they? They just sort of all have a singular goal. They want to eat you. They walk toward that goal and eat you. What I liked about the enemies in this was, even though they were direct duplicates, not only were they different from their above-world counterparts, but also they all had their own little personality quirks. That guy that was a dickhead in real life talking about the flare gun, he had a bit of a sense of humour as an underworlding guy. So it wasn't all shit for them down there, because that guy, somewhere, in that government facility, eating rabbits with scissors and being left to rot, still had a laugh. So even though the majority of that facility probably had people hating their lives and waiting for the untethering to occur, I reckon my man and maybe two or three other people with a bit of a sense of humour about the whole scenario may have been enjoying themselves down there. Probably not, though. I don't give ratings to films, but I will say that, like, just the way Jordan Peele writes, it's going to make me want to check out everything he does in the future until he does something that's, like, unforgivable, which I don't think he will do. Like I said, he did the Twilight Zone newest series of that, so I will check that at some point. But also, I know that the trailers just came out for the Candyman remake. He's directing the Candyman remake, and I just think, hopefully he's writing and directing it. I'm not sure about that, but if he is, it's going to be dope, because Candyman, it is a slasher horror character that's a bit slept on. You know, your Freddies and your Jasons and your thises and your thats, but not many people name check or check for Candyman. It was quite a creepy concept. I haven't seen the sequels, but I saw the first film multiple times, and it was an excellent little horror film. Just a creepy story about a photographer investigating a legend and then finding out there's far more to it than legend. From the trailer, it seems like they've changed the story slightly so that the Candyman is going to be the photographer guy. It's a guy photographer in this one as well. In the original, it was a female. But yeah, just because I have faith in Jordan Peele's writing, his choices for twists, and they're always brilliantly directed as well, I'm definitely looking forward to seeing Candyman as well. So that's all my thoughts on Us. It was an excellent film. I'm happy that I chose to make this the first film I reacted to, actually, because I've been waiting to see this film for a while, and it didn't disappoint. Jordan Peele, horror. Like I said, the show, what's strange is, the show Key and Peele, I found very hit and miss. When it was hit, it was hilarious. When it was miss, it was just almost like, it seemed like they were being a bit lazy that day writing it. But then, he started doing horrors, and out of nowhere, they're just like, all absolutely classy. In the future, they will be probably regarded as classics. And yeah, it's just a completely strange thing for me to see a guy that was a hit and miss comedy writer, even though I did enjoy a lot of the sketches on Key and Peele. I just did not enjoy a lot of the sketches on Key and Peele. So to see him so, in my opinion, before these horror films, so hit and miss as a writer, and then just absolutely knock it out of the park with the two he's done so far, yeah, I've got full faith in him that Candyman's going to be great. So that's all my thoughts on Us. Tune in next time, we will watch more. If you would like to recommend a film for me to react to, or a TV series for me to react to, let me know in the comments below. There are obviously quite a lot of things I've already seen, but I'm always willing to watch something if I haven't seen it, because I want these to be first time reactions, and also if enough other people want me to see it too. So until next time, enjoy your evenings and all that, have a good one, peace.